I'm in sound and I saw Star Trek The Original Series Episode 5, The Enemy Within. It is directed by Leo Penn, written by Richard Matheson, and if you haven't seen this episode, I will spoil it for you. Richard Matheson, I know him from The Twilight Zone. The Twilight Zone, if you've seen my reviews, he's done a few episodes of The Twilight Zone, and that's where I recognize this name. On with the review. This episode starts and we're seeing the USS Enterprise. They're surrounding this planet. They got some dudes beamed down to this planet, having a little bit of a dig, looking around on this planet, you know, the usual. And there's this guy who gets injured. He has some sort of yellow metal ore on him. What's fascinating is he goes through the transporter. The transporter's having issue catching on to a signal or something, and he's partially there, and then he dims down to not being there, and then he's there again. And it's like, oh, that's weird. Okay. All right. Something in this metal ore is causing the transporter to do a little bit of a malfunction. So immediately I'm like, all right, something's off. All right, let's beam up the captain. Let's beam up the captain of this ship. I don't think anyone knew there was something wrong with the transporter until like the captain was beamed up. So the captain gets beamed up and we got Scotty's like, all right, I'm gonna take you to your place. Let's go. Let's have a little bit of a gander. And then another copy of Kirk also gets beamed up. The differences between the two Kirks that got beamed up, one is kind of frail and weak. He's like, oh, I'm feeling off. But his temperament is pretty even keel, chill. This Kirk that got beamed up, oh, he's looking devilish. He's like, ha ha, yeah. And by the way, I love how William Shatner does a good job with representing two sides of Kirk throughout this episode. I'm like fully convinced that Kirk is both this dude who has like a good in him. And because he's got the good part of him is weaker, more frail, he's got like soft features in his face. Versus the bad version, the less good version of him, I'd say, has more harsh facial features. He's more aggressive. And so I like this. I like the subtleties between the two already. On top of this transporter being an issue, we got a bunch of dudes down on the planet surface whose nighttime gets really cold. Like, ridiculously cold. It just keeps getting colder and colder. I think the number was 120 degrees Fahrenheit, I think was the number exact. I could be wrong. But you know, it gets really cold and we got some dudes just down there and it's daylight right now, but it will get colder and we can't beam anyone up because the transporters are going to split people in two. Luckily, they catch this issue when it's just the captain. Unfortunately though, how are they going to fix this issue? And also, they got some men just down on the surface. So this is a big issue that's happening. And I'm like, oh man, I really hope they fix this transporter thing. They also beam up this dog thing. It looks like a dog. It looks like a dog in some costume. Jorb, is that the word? Dreads? Drag? I don't know what it's called. But we got this dog. It also beams up in two different personalities. And Kirk is informed of this. Is like, oh wow, there is the other side of me that's just roaming around. And you know what the other side of him is doing? He's just roaming around, walking the halls. He bursts into the medical bay, steals some brandy, I think, and starts drinking it. Slurp, slurp, slurp. He goes after Yeoman. I don't know how he got into her quarters. I mean, he's captain. I'm sure you found a way or something. But he got into Yeoman's quarters and is like, we're meant to be together. We're supposed to be loving together. And then he just forces her way onto her. And I'm like, oh, jeez. This is incredibly aggressive. It also goes to show that Kirk has feelings for Yeoman, and is actively not acting on them as acting. And when he's captain, like, you know, the two halves being whole, when he's like a whole captain, he feels for Yeoman but doesn't act on them. So I appreciate that. You gotta have some sort of structure, you gotta have some sort of command. You can't just have like a Yeoman of all people just sleeping with the captain. Then Yeoman can influence the captain's decisions. You don't want any of that. But we got a bad captain. He gets scratched on his face, and that's a good way to indicate which version of Kirk is on screen at any time. We're trying to find the bad version of Kirk. We got the good version of Kirk. He's becoming more indecisive. He's trying to rely on the people around him, Spock and Bones, and he's like, I'm having a hard time deciding what decision I want to make. And we got some men down there, and we got like dudes trying to fix the transporter, and it's great. So there's the tension is being built, and then on top of that, they're trying to find the bad version of Kirk. They go down to where all the cables and all the fun technologies there, and we got the good Kirk, and the bad Kirk is just like perching on top, and he's like, I'm gonna get you. And you know, they have a little bit of a tassel. They're like fighting over a phaser. A boom, a big old hole just happens in the middle of the transporter thing. And it's like, oh man, how are you gonna fix this transporter, man? You got a big old hole blasted through it. Oh my goodness. Maybe this will actually be helpful, because then you can just start off clean. But you gotta have the parts in order to fix the transporter. Luckily, the engineers on the USS Enterprise are incredibly clever. And I like how clever they are. So, I mean, it takes a lot of convincing for the good Kirk to like tell the bad Kirk, like, hey, you're going to be all right, because the bad Kirk, he's acting like an animal, but he's also dying. He gets weak and is dying. And I like how we have the good side of humanity, because this represents the good and bad in everyone. So the good side of humanity has faith, has fearlessness, is not afraid of what's going to happen in the future, because everything's gonna be good. That's what the good side believes. The bad side is where all the wild things are, your impulses, your bad impulses, your desire to hurt others, to desire to be selfish and only do what you want to do and not even care at all about the safety and regards of anyone else. But that side of you also doesn't know how to deal with the bad times. They're just constantly scared. That side of you is constantly scared and needs the good side of you in order to tell the bad side of you that everything's gonna be okay. But also it's the bad side of you that allows you to command, because the good side is very indecisive. If you're good, then you're like, yeah, I just want everyone to just do whatever, just do your thing. Whereas the bad side of your humanity wants everyone to do what you want to do. You want to force everyone else to do your thing. And so the good of a person is not defined by how, you know, good person is. It's taking the strength of like the bad side of humanity and keeping that under control and using that bad side of you, like the strength to lead, for example, and using that for the good of everyone else. And that's like a power struggle that every person has to deal with. But I really appreciate this episode's just literal look at the two sides of humanity. And I really like this episode for that. Oh my goodness, we got the transporter fixed. Wow, we got the transporter fixed. Let's send those two dogs. The one half and then the other half of the same dog. Let's send them through. Oh no, the dog died. Risk. We don't want Captain Kirk to die, but we got the intelligence side of him is going to let him know that everything's gonna be fine. You have to take the risk, Captain Kirk. the good side of Captain Kirk is becoming more and more indecisive, to the point where the people around him are like, hey, you got two different options, pick one. And he's like, I don't want to decide. And he's like, someone please decide for me. He's like, are you relinquishing your command? No, I'm not. Okay, then you have to make your decision yourself. So we send Kirk through the transporter, and then luckily he's one whole person. Let's just send everybody. Come on, we gotta send these men off of this ice planet. By the way, everyone's, they're just all freezing. Luckily, they're not dead. They didn't die. The phasers, very clever. They just heat rocks nearby with phasers. I also didn't know that phasers could go out, but one of them did go out, and there's three still working. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. Nice world building moment. I like this episode a lot. You could probably tell by how much detail I gave during this reveal. I like all the performances of all the actors. I like the world building. I just like the fleshing out of two sides of humanity, because that's something you gotta deal with when you're advanced society. Even if you're part of Star Trek, you know, you have a bunch of Starfleets everywhere, all the hyper organization of humanity, you still have to deal with human nature. And I like this episode's reflection on human nature. So I gotta give this episode a solid 8.8 out of 10. If you like this review, watch another one. The platform really likes that. If you want a fast track boot review, you can do that for $20 redinos at patreon.com/ASCPresents. And if you'd like to help support the daily grind of all them daily movies, go to this link tree. Find the way you can help support the daily grind of all them daily movies, so you can go here. And until next time, min salad sauce. See you later to my salad croutons and bacon bits. Okay. Beam me up.